Hello friends, I am Sanjeev B. Naik, Assistant Professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, I am going to solve some problems on design of welded joints. At the end of the session, students will be able to solve problems on design of welded joints. Pause the video and just recall the design procedure of various welded joints you have learnt. This is an example in which two plates are joined together by means of fillet weld. So these are the two plates which are joined by parallel fillet weld as shown over here. And the leg dimension of the weld is 10 mm, that is the size of the weld is 10 mm, and the permissible shear stress at the throat section is 75 Newton per mm square. Determine the length of each weld L as shown over here. If 15 mm weld length is required for starting and stopping of the weld run. So as far as the solution is concerned, these are the two plates and these are the parallel fillet welds which are subjected to load of 35 kN. So P value is 35 kN. And the size of the weld given in the problem is 10 mm and that is H, and the allowable shear stress is given. So now to design this weld joint, it is subjected to shearing action. So this weld and this weld, they are subjected to shearing stress, and that's why the strength of this welded joint is obtained as shearing area of one weld, which is obtained as 0.707 into H into L multiplied by allowable shearing stress. This is the strength of one fillet, whereas there are two fillets, so total strength of the joint, that is load carrying capacity joint, will be P is equal to 2 times 0.707 HL into tau. Substituting the values given, we obtain this, and then from this we get the length required is a 33 mm. So the length required here for carrying the load effectively is 33 mm. However, we have to add 15 mm length to this for starting and stopping of weld run, because when welder starts welding, initial sum of the length, proper weld is not been obtained, and the same case happens when you want to stop the weld run, and that's why some allowance is been kept at the start and the end, and that has been given here as a 15 mm. So total length required is 48 mm. That is given as a 40. So this length L is required to be 48 mm. This is another example where two plates are joined by fillet welds as shown over here, which are transverse. So transverse fillet welds are perpendicular to the load. So these two welds are transverse, and the plate width is 120 mm thick and thickness is 12.5 mm, and these are joined by double transverse weld as I shown here. The welded joint is subjected to tensile force of 150 kN. So total force applied here is 150 kN tensile. Determine the length of the weld if the allowable tensile stress for the weld material is 120 Newton per mm square. So we have given a transverse fillet weld, two transverse fillet weld. We have to design the length for this. So to obtain the solution, the data given is here, load is given, width of the plate and size of the weld is equal to size of the thickness of the plate. So that's why H is also 12.5 mm. Now this particular transverse fillet weld is subjected to tensile failure. So we have to consider the tensile strength of the joint, welded joint. So once again, the failure area is a throat area, and that has been taken as 0.707 H into L. Now there are two such welds are there, so 2 times the area is the total area of failure multiplied by allowable tensile stress, because the failure stress is a tensile. So we consider the safe limit that is allowable to decide the capacity of this welded joint to sustain the load, and that we call as strength. So strength of this weld required is this equation. So we know that it has to be subjected to 150 kN load. So we take this as a p-value and we solve it for L. So So L obtained here is 70.72 mm. So this is the way we can design the required parameter of the joint, that is the length, and solution is obtained. This is another example of an angle. So asymmetric section is considered here, and this is an angle subjected to parallel welds having some length L1 and L2 as shown in the figure, and the size of the angle is 200 mm height, 100 mm width, and 10 mm thickness as shown in this figure, and the total force acting is 150 kN, and it is passing through CZ of the weld section, and permissible shear stress is 70 Newton per mm square. So what you have to do is determine the length L1 and L2, that is at the top and bottom. So here we find that the total length, if it is L, that is L1 and L2, the load applied causes the shearing failure. So parallel welds are subjected to shearing failure when such load is applied, and that's why total shearing strength can be considered here as a P. And that's why total shearing strength of the weld P is throat area multiplied by tau, that is the allowable shear stress. So that total load applied is 150 kN, and that's why the total length L comprising L1 plus L2 is calculated first as a L value, 303.09 mm. Now, however, this L has to be divided into L1 and L2. Now, to divide this one, we take one more statics law into account, that is a summation of moment about CG is 0 here. So, we take this load into distance is a moment P1 into Y1 and P2 into Y2. However, the strength P1 is proportional to length L1 because throat size is same and material property is same. So, just load is proportional to L1. So, the moment if I want to get to obtain the lengths L1 and L2, I get the moment as L1 Y1 is equal to L2 Y2, where L1 is the distance, Y1 is the distance shown over here, which is nothing but 71.8. And L2, Y1 is the distance, which is a 200 minus 71.8, and Y2 is a distance 71.8. So substituting this Y1 and Y2, we can get the relationship between L1 and L2. And also we know that the total length L is L1 plus L2. Solving this 1 and 2, we can come to conclusion, that is what is L1 and what is L2. So here L1 obtained is 108 mm, 0.81 mm, and 194.28 mm is the value of L2. So this is the way required length is calculated. Now consider another example where a 100 mm wide plate and 10 mm thick plate is welded to another steel plate by two parallel fillet welds. So by means of double parallel fillet weld and a single transverse fillet weld. So one single transverse and double parallel fillet weld. So this way two plates are connected, and the permissible tensile and shear stresses for the weld material and the plate are 70 Newton and 50 Newton per mm square respectively. Find the length of each parallel fillet weld. That means we have to decide this length L, assuming the tensile force acting on the plate as static, that is the load acting is a static. So in such case, being the strength of the plate and strength of the joint is same, first we have to calculate the solution for strength of the plate is considered. So as we know that the plate is also subjected to tensile failure, the load is equal to failure area of the plate cross sectional area, that is width into thickness, and allowable tensile stress. And that gives us P is equal to 100 is the width of the plate, 10 is the thickness, and 70 is allowable tensile stress as a given data. And that's why load is 70,000 Newton. So the strength of the plate is 70,000, and that's why the strength of the weld is also required to be 70,000 Newton total strength. Now that strength is been sustained by parallel plates as well as transverse plate. So now if I assume that P1 is the strength of this parallel fillet weld is subjected to shear failure. So considering shearing failure, I can calculate the strength of this parallel fillet weld as a P1. and that is 2 times the area of single weld because it is a double parallel plate weld. So already we know that is 2 into 0.707 HL into tau, and substituting this value we can obtain value of P1 in terms of L as 707 into L. Now we take a P2 is the strength which has been for transverse where it is subjected to tensile failure. So tensile area, failure area into tensile stress is the value of P2, and that has been obtained as 49,490 newton. So this is the way we have calculated the strength of transverse fillet and strength of parallel as well as the total strength of the weld. And that's why we know that total strength of the weld is P. P1 and P2 are obtained, and if we equate this one we can calculate the required length L to be 29.01 mm. So that's why the length required here is 29.01 mm. As a solution we can obtain. So these are my references. Thank you.